Hello everyone! Today we're going to be talking about the foraging skill. So by the end of the video, you're going to know everything there is to know about picking stuff up off the ground. Basically, that's how it works. You pick something up off the ground that's considered a forageable good. It gives you foraging experience. The more you level it up, the better it gets, the more reward it gives you, just like any other of your skills. It's also the one that people often level up the soonest because they tend to pick up a lot of stuff as they're running around in the early game. It's pretty much the best thing to do. It gives you a lot of energy, it gives you a lot of experience, it can make you a lot of money if you do it right. Now, when you start a new game, there will be forageable goods spawned all over the world. You can run around and pick them up. They spawn in pretty much every area in the game. They all act pretty similar. They change throughout the seasons. There's basically four that change throughout the seasons. There's four for spring, four for summer, four for fall, and even four for winter. With a few varying berries and such in the middle of all the months that show up in mass for only a few short days, but I'll get more on those later. After picking all the forageable items on the map, like you'll probably do in your first day or two, it's important to note that you'll get 2 to 5 new ones appearing for every area every single day. Now, what constitutes an area, you might ask? It's anywhere with a transition like this. Obviously, like all skills, it starts out at 0 when you start the game and can go all the way up to level 10. So the more you forage along the way, the higher that skill is gonna get. As I mentioned earlier, there are berries that show up throughout the seasons. From the 15th to 18th of spring is a great chance to upgrade your foraging skill because there's salmon berries everywhere. If you want to get your skill up high, go around and collect as many of those as you can for those 3 days from the 15th to the 18th. Every time you level up your foraging skill, you will increase your axe proficiency by just a little bit. So by the time you're all the way to level 10, you use 1 less energy to swing your axe. Instead of using 2 energy, you need 1. That's entirely not worth it, but it's a little bit of a help, so whatever. And there are basically 3 ways to get foraging experience. One is simply by obviously picking up the forageable goods you find around the map. The second is by chopping wood. If I chop down this tree, you get experience. Only from the tree itself though, not the stump however. You get the lump sum of that experience once you chop down the tree itself on the very last hit. The stumps don't do anything for you, they're good for wood, but give you no foraging experience. It is important to remember that. Now, the typical foraged items you pick up around the world, the leeks, the salmon berries, they give you 7 experience each, along with the truffles that pigs can drop should you ever get to that point. The trees give you better, they give you 12 experience by the time you chop them down, and the last way to get foraging experience is to grow wild seeds. And aside from those things, the best way to get foraging experience is to chop these bigger stumps, this one here and the one up here. They will give you hardwood and 25 experience each, so that's more than the 12 you get for trees or the 7 from the regular forageable goods. That is one big advantage of the forest farm if you're into forageable goods, because you have all this wood that spawns here every single day to get you huge amounts of experience. You can get an easy 200 experience just from chopping these 8 hardwood stumps. Those 8 stumps, combined with the other forageable goods and these stumps that show up initially, are quite a bit of experience, so they'll give you a good boost ahead. Like I said, the forageable goods can be worth a lot of money. For example, if you manage to find the mushroom floor down in the mines, you can get a whole bunch of mushrooms here in a single day, several hundred of them. They're all very valuable and they all give you 7 experience each, so you can do the math. If you get 100, 700 experience plus all the money. Plus, the higher your skill gets from all that experience, the more valuable everything becomes because you find more forageable goods and their quality gets higher. For those of you that don't know, the mushroom floor spawns in the mines. It goes between floor 80 and 120. You can find it randomly. Every day it moves shallower one floor. That means if it's on floor 83 one day, it will be on floor 82 the next day. It's always down there in the mines. You can find it again and again. Wait till it's on the floor just before an elevator and go get as many mushrooms as you can possibly carry in one day. You'll get many tens of thousands of gold and lots of experience. That is one reason I say foraging experience is so good, because mushrooms. Especially in the early days of your very first spring, if you can find the mushroom level, you can get 10, 20,000 gold before you can even have many crops done, so what's not to like? Anyways, let's look at the benefits of upgrading your foraging skill. At level 1, plus 1 axe proficiency, which I talked about, it doesn't really make a difference. Even once you get all the way to level 10, it only saves you 1 energy out of the 2 you have to use to start with, so don't even worry about that. Trees sometimes drop seeds. Okay, that's not bad. They'll give you some seeds if you bother to plant those. I never do. You can also craft wild seeds, which are actually pretty valuable to sell in their box, and the field snacks are pretty valuable. Once you're cutting down all those trees, they'll give you the crap you need to make those field snacks, and that's just easy energy. Level 2 doesn't come with much. Another plus 1 axe proficiency and a survival burger. The survival burger is a recipe, it's something you can make. It's not overly useful, being that I've never ever made one in my entire playthrough. By then you're probably finding other forageable goods that will pretty much replace it anyway. It doesn't take the effort to make those, you just pick them up. At level 3, we can make a tapper. Tappers are a little bit hard to make. They take hardwood and some other ingredients, but they can be worth it. You put them on trees. The trees produce different things depending on what kind of tree they are. Three different types of trees, three different things they can produce. The stuff you get can be sold if need be. They grow all year round as long as they're on a tree. Just takes a few days. The thing I really like that for is ingredients you get in those tappers you make use to make better things, such as rain totems, which I find very, very useful. At level 4, we can make a charcoal kiln, which is actually pretty handy if you're doing a lot of mining. That just turns wood into coal, which is very handy because if you're upgrading your foraging skill, you're probably chopping a lot of wood, more than you're going to need, might as well turn it into something useful. You can also make summer wild seeds, so those are good once you get into summer. And plus one wild berry harvesting is actually really good. Like I said, in the middle of spring or the middle of fall, the middle of summer, whenever the berries are out, that gives you an opportunity to get even more berries. That's extra experience for you and just extra energy. I mean, they're 25 energy each. They're not worth anything to sell, but you do get a lot of them. At foraging level 5, like any skill, we get a choice. Either forester, where wood is worth 50% more. I wouldn't waste your time on this. I doubt you're selling any wood. If you are, stop it. It's not worth very much. Sell something useful. Gatherer is the one you want. Chance for double harvest of foraged items. Why wouldn't you want that? You have a chance to get twice as many of the items you're trying to get. And that, again, that's twice the experience, twice everything. And then level 6 rolls around. Now we can make lightning rods. Those are handy. Once you make them, you put them in your field. Lightning will occasionally strike them on rainy days. One day later, they'll produce a battery. Batteries are good for some of the endgame items. You definitely want lots of those. Make lightning rods whenever you can. Wild seeds for fall. That's pretty self-explanatory. And we can start making warp totems. This one will take you to the beach. Maybe not really worth the effort of making one. If you feel like it, sure, it will just warp you to the beach once you use it, and then it disappears. So have fun making that so you can save yourself 30 seconds of walking. At level 7, unsurprisingly, is more of the same. We get winter wild seeds, which are actually pretty good. They're the only thing you can plant in winter, so might as well stock up on those if you feel like doing that. There's not much else to do for winter, and a warp totem to the mountains, which is probably even less useful than the beach because the mountains aren't very far. I could walk there by the time I'm done this sentence. I just walk up here and then to the right. So probably not worth making, but if you feel like doing it, sure, why not? I won't stop you. At level 8, we get another plus 1 for wild berry harvesting, which is even better again. By the time you get to level 8 foraging, it probably doesn't make a huge deal, but on the off chance it does, great, you're leveling up your foraging skill fast, and those wild berries do make a world of difference if you need them. And probably the best warp totem of all, the one that actually takes you back to the farm from wherever you are. So if you're way down in Skull Cavern, instantly back, no passing out. Some are stupid up by the quarry, trapped in the rocks. Use the warp totem, you'll get back. It's the best one there is. That is the best as far as warp totems go, because at level 9, we get my favorite totem, the rain totem. Guess what that does? If you use that, it makes a weird sound, and then the next day it rains. Obviously, it's not the sound that I'm after, though it is amusing. Still can't figure out what that is. The rain the next day means you don't have to water your crops. So in some of my early videos when I did the mega crops, I didn't use sprinklers for those. I just used 15 rain totems. I saved up and saved up. I did this all manually without cheats, by the way. Then I used rain totems for 15 days in a row. Didn't have to take up the room to use sprinklers for my crops. Didn't have to water the crops. Just watched them grow while I sat back. Had like a $4 million crop just because of that. Easy peasy. So then at level 10, we're left with another choice due to our earlier pick. We can choose between the botanist, which means forged columns are always your highest quality, that's iridium quality, or a tracker, location of forageable items revealed. This one's up to you. If you want to find more forageable items at this point, great. And generally by the time you're at level 10, you don't really need to find a lot. And that's why I go with the botanist, that way when you do find them, they're always iridium quality. That means those truffles you pick up from the pigs, always iridium, very, very valuable. They definitely make worth having the pigs worth it. They definitely make those pigs worth your time because every truffle you pick up is iridium quality, lots of money. Same with everything else you pick up. You'll pick it up, it will be iridium quality, more energy, more health, and more value if they're a valuable item. Hi Linus. Forageable items can make gifts too. Obviously the higher the quality, the more people like them. Unless they're a poisonous mushroom, then Linus doesn't want to eat it. I think that about covers the foraging skill. If there's anything I forgot, let me know. Like I was saying, the foraging skill can be hugely beneficial in the early game. It can get you all the energy you could need, because you definitely have a limited amount of energy when you start the game. It's really your limiting factor, so forge as many things as you can, get as much energy as you can, and it really helps you later in the game. Also, head straight for that mushroom level as soon as you can. If you find it, you'll get a huge jump in the game. I think they're gonna nix it as soon as they can with an update because it just gives you too much stuff, so use it while you can get it. Anyways, hope you like this one. Thank you all for watching.